discussing about cache memories. In this video, we will study about performance of cache. Cache performance is based on average memory access time, that is, the average time a processor takes to get a data request. Average memory access time is equals to hit time plus miss rate into miss penalty. Cache hit time is the time to find the block in cache and return it to the CPU. Cache miss rate is the ratio of number of cache misses to the total number of cache access. Cache miss penalty is the extra time or extra processor stall cycles while accessing next level memory in case of cache misses. Here we have a formula for CPU performance. CPU performance is equals to CPI without stalls plus memory stalled CPI. This memory stalled CPI is equal to miss per instruction into miss penalty. We have a question. Memory access per instruction is 20%. Miss rate is 2%. Miss penalty is 400 cycles. Find memory stall cycles. So now memory stall CPI. Memory stall CPI is equals to miss per instruction into miss penalty. Now miss per instruction here will be miss rate into memory access per instruction. Miss rate is 0.02 and memory access per instruction is 0.2. So miss per instruction will be 0.004. So memory stall CPI will be 0.004 into miss penalty, that is 400. So memory stall CPI will be 1.6. Next we have unified cache and split cache. In unified cache, instructions and data are loaded in the same cache memory. It can lead to structural hazard. In split cache, instructions and data are loaded in separate cache. Now we have 6 cache optimizations. Cache optimization techniques are based on improving average memory access time. We know that average memory access time is equals to hit time plus miss rate into miss penalty. So we can reduce average memory access time by reducing the hit time, miss rate and miss penalty. Miss rate can be reduced by larger block size, larger cache size and higher cache associativity. Next, miss penalty can be reduced by multi-level cache and giving priority to read miss over write. Then hit time can be reduced by avoiding address translation while indexing the cache. So these are the 6 cache optimizations that we have to study. So first optimization is larger block size to reduce miss rate. By having larger cache block size, we can accommodate more words in cache. Hence, cache miss rate can be reduced. But larger cache block size can sometimes lead to increase miss penalty. Suppose the capacity of a cache block is 4 words and capacity of channel, that is the bandwidth connecting the cache and main memory, is 4 words per unit time. If we increase the block size to 8 words while the channel capacity unaltered, the channel has to access the main memory 2 times. Hence miss penalty, that is the extra time to fetch the word from next level of memory, get increased twice. Second optimization is larger cache size to reduce miss rate. By having larger cache size, more blocks can be accommodated. Hence, there are chances of less miss. But if we have larger cache size, hit time will be more. Also, there will be high cost, area and power. Third optimization is higher associativity to reduce miss rate. On increasing associativity of cache, as we can reduce conflict miss and hence miss rate. But increased associativity can lead to more number of tag comparison, hence more hit time. Next we have optimization 4, multi-level cache to reduce miss penalty. By having multi-level cache, we can have reduced miss penalty, that is the extra time to fetch the word from next level of memory. Here, average memory access time will be hit time of level 1 cache plus miss rate of level 1 cache into miss penalty of level 1 cache. Now, miss penalty of level 1 cache will be hit time to level 2 cache plus miss rate of level 2 cache into miss penalty of level 2 cache. Now here we have concept of local miss rate and global miss rate. Local miss rate is the total number of misses in the cache divided by total number of memory access to that very cache. Global miss rate is the total number of misses in the cache divided by total number of memory access generated by the processor. Let's suppose CPU generates 100 memory references. Out of 100, there are 80 hits in cache L1 and 20 misses. Hence, remaining 20 reference will be searched in cache level 2. Let out of 20, there are 15 hits in cache level 2 and 5 misses. So, for level 1 cache, local miss rate will be 20 out of 100, that is 0.2. And global miss rate will be again 20 out of 100, that is 0.2. For level 2 cache, local miss rate will be 5 out of 20, that is 0.25, and global miss rate will be 5 out of total CPU references, CPU generated references. So 5 out of 100, that is 0.05. Here is one formula for global miss rate for second level cache also. Global miss rate for level 2 cache is local miss rate of level 1 cache into local miss rate of level 2 cache. Now we have a question. Suppose that in 1000 memory references, there are 40 misses in first level cache and 20 misses in second level cache. What are the various miss rates? Assume that miss penalty from the level 2 cache to memory is 200 clock cycles. The hit time to level 2 cache is 10 clock cycles. The hit time of level 1 cache is 1 clock cycle, and there are 1.5 memory references per instructions. What is the average memory access time? So, for level 1 cache, local miss rate will be 40 out of 1000, that is 0.04, and global miss rate also will be 40 out of 1000, that is 0.04. Now, for level 2 cache, local miss rate will be 20 out of 40, that is 0.5, and global miss rate will be 20 out of total memory references generated by CPU, that is 1000, that is 0.02. Now, average memory time is equals to hit time of level 1 plus miss rate level 1 into memory into miss penalty level 1. Now, miss penalty of level 1 will be hit time of level 2 plus miss rate of level 2 into miss penalty level 2. That is hit time of level 1 plus miss rate of level 1 into hit time of level 2 plus miss rate level 2 into miss penalty of level 2. Now hit time of level 1 is 1 clock cycle, miss rate of level 1 is 0.04 into hit time of level 2 is 10 clock cycles plus miss rate of level 2 is 0.4, that is the local miss rate of level 2, and multiplied by miss penalty of level 2, that is 200 clock cycles. Hence, the average memory access time came out to be 111.04 clock cycles. So that's all for this video. We will continue our discussion on optimizations in the next video. Thank you.